Pelo aquilo ele disse, olha the start.
Oh, they've changed this.
They changed the river.
Yeah.
Okay, what happens? The zoo starts as a result of a film made in the country, and there are some animals, wild animals. So there was this lady who decided to start her own zoo, which ended up to be the best zoo in the world, you know? So, because the most indigenous life in Belize is at the zoo. Manatees are endangered. You have a very healthy population of the West Indian manatee. Black howler monkeys are endangered. This is what they encourage you to have a poster, keep a poster instead of a parrot. Like the lady had a parrot, they will encourage her to have a poster where she can see parrots, many parrots.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if you folks are the snakes, but there are quite a few snakes in here, including a boa constrictor, which is the biggest snake in the country. I guess you can see the deadliest of all snakes you have in Greece, which happens to be there. What we call locally Balba Maria. Yellow Jam, or Tomica, is the French lance, a French name. And I guess you can also see the biggest of all snakes in the area. Happens to be a boa constrictor. I don't know which one is which, but there's both here. Okay, here's one.
Here's the boa.
Here's one.
Oh, yeah, there's another one here.
They get blind, so you have to be keen on your eyes. I've seen some people come here, where's the snake? Where's the snake? And they don't see a snake. But that's a snake.
Okay, it's in there.
I think it's in the corner.
No, this is the yellow one.
You know that?
It's in there.
Oh, no.
There's
a skin. Yellow jars are going active at night. So poor chance of seeing during the day, unless you are
massive
in the jungle and you wake them up.
Slightly, but it's got so-called.
A lot of cane fields are burnt, and when they go for cane, they find remnants, they find burnt, all kind of snakes. In particular, wild snakes and ferlands, which are the two deadliest snakes. Oh yeah, this is a wawa.
Food, well, how was the food?
Oh, it's not. It's not good.
Fish?
No.
We have a picture of you up there.
Okay, let's come this way and we come back that way, guys.
This is the way we're coming back, so we'll go this way first.
My body novello.
Hey, eres tú acá andas.
¿Qué andas?
And we have a good man, amigos.
Hey, how are you?
And he's always smiling because he has that mask. He doesn't seem happy, but he's smiling. He's a happy guy. Good to see you, amigo.
Yeah, buddy.
This is the first time I've ever seen a tapir. I've always wanted to see it.
Their noses are...
Okay, we
it's
have
huge!
Two
here he comes.
Let me get back to the white tail.
Here, put your hand down.
There's a ton of them.
Put your hand down.
Hi! I'm so nervous.
Hi!
These are our bigger wildlife in Belize.
Yeah, this is crazy.
Yeah, you put your hand, he'll sniff, and sometimes they lick you.
I'm so nervous.
They're so gentle. Look at their feet.
Oh! Yeah.
Three toes. So when you see them in the mud in the jungle, freshly, you can tell it's a tapir.
Small horse.
Tapir trail. Tapir truck.
Apparently not a fan of cucumbers. Except for that one.
That's the best cucumber.
I like cucumber juice.
It's too cute, dude. Yeah, dude. This is cool. Oh, yeah. That cucumber is delicious. He makes it look very tasty.
Okay, yeah, we have a tapir. And like myself, I love juices.
They're so mellow.
He's mellow.
Cucumber juice. This guy looks like he's a fan of cukes.
I like how their nose like comes in kind of like an accordion.
Uh-huh. Are you gonna come back over here and take a whiff?
Tapirs.
My hand?
There are quite a few tapirs here at the zoo.
Oh, hello. No biting.
No bite.
No bite. You know, you can sniff somebody else's hand.
Yeah, go sniff her hand. I'm nervous.
Yeah, I love that we're not allowed to pet dogs, but you're almost getting bitten by a tapir every time.
Would you like some tapir saliva?
Yeah, I'm cool with the tapir saliva.
I think Shanti does that.
I know.
Yeah, that nose, though.
Isn't it cool? Mm-hmm. Put your hand out there. Let him sniff you. He's just curious. These guys get...
Oh, my God.
Found a spot.
Yeah, there it is.
Apparently I have the stinky hand. But...
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he sniffed mine once. He was like, no, thanks. You got all the deep.
Got all the deep.
Oh. This is just our first animal. Think of how much fun we're going to have here.
Yeah, they're all petting animals, right?
No. That's the only one that really comes up and pays attention to you.
Yeah.
Okay, here we have one or two species of deer found in the area. This is the white-tailed deer. So they are the zoo. Red bracket deer are also found in the area. Now what is interesting about these guys here at the zoo? They have a 30-inch high fence, which they can easily jump and run away. These guys with jump fences.
What'd you find?
12 feet in height. But there we can see this one has a...
Back. Did you see the one that's kind of close?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
I see him.
Yeah. See, that's what I like, the zoo, because they have like, this is a nice enclosure.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I love where they're keeping it. It's huge.
Yep. Oh, hello. I think that's our friend. Yep, it's our friend. Yeah. He's wandering in the other part of his enclosure.
It's April.
Oh, I didn't even know there was another part.
Well, April.
Yeah, I knew April's hot. Never mind. He was getting his feet wet somewhere.
Hey, a swimming pool.
That's where it is.
Cute. Hanging out.
A little mahogany.
Being a tapir. You're huge, dude. Tapir. A T-A.
There's also some. There's been iguanas in here.
A tapper. Yeah, I like that.
I think the iguanas just like to come to the zoo.
I think they just like eating the food of the other animals.
Mm.
Oh, you're on a timeout, aren't you? Oh, I think you can get through.
Look at
those with our cars on accident back home.
Face.
Yeah, I guess Grace is right. They do kind of look a little different.
Hello.
Oh,
climate probably affects it.
You got any snacks?
Hi. I don't know if he has what she's got, man. Or he is. Oh,
well, I realize that now.
Bambi.
Before or after he lost his mother?
Oh, look at that, Dr. Jones. Get him. Up here, Dr. Jones.
Oh.
It's a pure kissing a rhino.
You have the light, everything is. Oh, a video. Let me get him in the video. He's crawling up. Let me try getting him. He's crawling up.
That's our buddy again. Decided to take a nap.
He almost did eat a lot just now.
Yeah, they get the veggies that they get are exquisite. Spider monkey. So these are darker than we usually see in the U.S. The spider monkeys that they have in the U.S. usually are the lighter subspecies. These are the darker ones. Whack.
Yeah, I hit Diego with my bag.
There's usually more than one. Yeah, the other one's up there. Doing something. They have two enclosures and there's two troops of them. So one is here and one is in the next thing. One troop's here and another's in the other enclosure. Sparks.
We don't have enough parks here. Or five cats we have, most of them get to see all of them.
You can take everything
you
need, I
can
take it home with me.
Shall we see some sparks, maybe two?
I'll pay customs all of my money.
Turtles.
Turtle.
Fish.
I'll pay customs all of my money to let me have a tiger in a little kitty.
Oh, no, in Belize, you're not allowed to have wildlife. Not anymore.
So, do you know if there's like garlic growing?
Parrots,
I smell
yeah,
it.
Yeah, if you get cut.
I don't know. See the turtles and the fish? Some,
yeah.
Lots of turtles.
Mm-hmm.
There's a little raft for them, too.
Sometimes when you go to Lamanai, we sneak up on them, we get to see them.
Parrots?
No, turtles.
They're so cute.
Oh.
What do you see?
Okay, so see those two fish over there?
Yeah.
They have like a bunch of fry. So those are parents, and all their young are swimming around.
Oh wow. My god!
They're protecting
you. What did you discover?
So there's like two fish over there, but all the they had all their babies up at the surface, but now they're all gone.
You have to go and explain that.
They may not be around long with all these turtles.
Mm-hmm. That's why they're sticking close.
Protecting them.
Turtles everywhere.
I can't see a fish protecting me.
Four turtles.
And little fish on the turtle.
These are like painted turtles.
Mm-hmm.
It's moss. It's moss on your back. You have
yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, there are quite a few turtles in there. Mm-hmm. I think you should paint 1, 2, 3, number them.
What's that one say?
Yeah, Didi will share access back to him.
Mm-hmm.
Shortcut to see the jaguar jungle.
Yeah, that will be later, the jaguars.
Why are we skipping the jaguar jungle?
We're not going to skip the jaguars. We're just not.
Oh, freshwater fish from Belize. Is that what we're supposed
like to the croak of a frog?
Yep.
That's the color of the toucan.
I know who can. Toucan.
They're like a croak of a frog, dear Josh.
Yeah.
That's the color of the toucan.
Yeah. They're like chattering on the beach.
That's the color of the toucan, my friends. It's not.
I don't think it's so wild when you just take off their beak and it's a human face.
If one comes, two comes.
No baby.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a little baby.
Thank you.
What's
I'm gonna think it's warm. I'm gonna go
get one. Diego, what do you think about jaguars? What do you think about jaguars? How do you know when you're being hunted? When you can't see them on top of the cage.
Oh.
Oh, wow.
That's cheeky.
Right hand side.
On top of the cage.
It's weird that it. I already said this once, but I said cheeky before I realized this guy's name.
She's over on the cage.
Let's see if I can get a shot from over here.
I don't think she's in like the worst place for taking a picture.
Mm-hmm. The other species here is a little bigger. And this one, if it was raining, it would be smelly, but locals claim this is very tasty, better than pork meat or
any other peccary.
One. Mm-hmm. Peccary, yes. There are two species. That one has a couple young, couple young with mama, still rely on mama.
All right, guys. That's
one. Yeah, very tasty, the clam. Well, I used to eat them before, but you know, wild.
Yeah, these are they're small wild pigs. People eat them all over South America.
It's a delicacy.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully, we get to see later on the royal rat, which was fed to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth, and the reason why it got the name royal rat because Queen Elizabeth. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Become the sweat.
Becoming it. I'm gonna swim in my own sweat.
This is the sixth time I've come to the zoo, and this is the first time that they've been out close enough to really get a good look.
Wow.
It's just every time you come, there's a different experience. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's during the morning, smelly, bad.
When it's wet, it smells, yeah.
It feels like there's so many firsts happening this year on this
trip. There's always firsts every year, different things. Like we got a better look at the howler monkeys than we usually do. Usually they're farther back.
I think the last time these were before the cougar. You remember that empty?
There was some, that was like 4 years ago. Last time I was here, they were here.
Right there?
Yeah. Okay.
Oh yeah. Yeah, this drone, you've seen them, I think. Berries.
They look like berries or grapes or something.
Oh, it looks like palm dates. Just not really cool.
Anybody want a bathroom break? No. You good?
Home with me. No, give customs everything.
When you enter the ground, you sign up on your pier and you have the jaguar encounter.
Outhouse that way.
I'm not sure if we did it any time, but can you?
Sometimes, but we always ended up doing it when they were already out here.
Yeah.
Cheeky boy.
I think I have seen people do it. The jaguar encounter. That would be neat, Diego.
Yeah, it would be neat.
I don't know how much to pay. I don't remember. Maybe $100 each.
Jeez.
And then you need to sign your will in my name. Yes.
Okay. Okay. Specifically yours.
Yeah.
Are you awake again?
Everybody got a nice, a good picture of the cougar.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he's still around.
I think this is the first time we get to see him this close.
Yeah, he looks so
oh my gosh.
You're awesome.
Yeah, every time we have trouble locating them, finding them. Oh, he's even giving us a show.
Oh, dude, he probably got some cool ones of the
yawning. My guess is this is immature. Well, he acts immature.
Mm-hmm.
He's not a full-grown adult. He's not a full-grown adult.
Hi.
Hi, he's coming over to us.
No.
Not today.
I'm done, y'all. I'm heading out. Dude, I bet you got some cool ones of him yawning.
Yeah, maybe. It's hard with the
Yeah, mine were all fuzzy.
It's hard with the cage.
Yeah.
You just gotta get that.
guys, when I go around with a group of tourists at any site, I usually put a name to my group. So if I see, now we will call ourselves cougars. When I say cougars, I am calling on you.
Okay.
So I don't get the attention of everybody in the group, no? Okay, cougars, where is them? Cougar number four. Where's cougar number four? Oh, right behind me. Okay.
He's watching you from the tree.
Doctor, who knows about this?
It's like birch bark or something.
Trees shed their leaves to conserve water. Deciduous trees do in the dry season. So whenever it rains, they acquire newer greener leaves.
Mm.
But this one shed its bark. Trees will shed their bark because they will never be an air. They will never allow any air plants to grow there. The ancient edifies, orchids, or anything to it. Now, what we have here, we call locally the tourist tree. And why the tourist tree? Because the bark is spilling out like tourists going snorkeling, swimming, fishing, or fishing. And they get some burnt. And that's why they call it the tourist tree. No, the Maya name for this is Chaka. Chaka. Chak is red. Chaka. Now we have seen, not any time and not every time, but guys will always tell you that when you see this, you will see the poison wood next to it.
Mm.
Poison wood we call in Maya Chichem. And if you pass by and just creep a Chichem tree, you can bet that something will happen depending on how, if you're allergic, that's terrible. You know, it swells and you get burned, you know, black. And if you realize this occurred, what you do with a knife, you scrape it and you get the sap, rub it immediately. Mm. Nothing will happen. You know, the antidote for this heals the poison wood. So, Mother Nature has provided this to be in the vicinity of any poison wood. So if you knew, you'd be in good shape. Not necessarily the other way around, but these are always found close to a poison wood tree. Some guys will tell you that you always find them together. But,
thank you. Hello, kitties. What are you doing?
Then we have the smallest of the five cats. But unlike the other cats, this one does not have the tiger or the fish.
We see these sometimes running across the road.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Here, Rebecca, you can go right in front of me.
Well, these guys stand 6 feet tall, a wingspan of 3 meters, which is like...
Yeah, this isn't a full adult one.
Yeah.
Because we see them when we go to laminate sometimes far off in the distance. And you can, and you can tell what they're...
These guys are endangered. Endangered. Okay, you ready to see a huge, gigantic, enormous, humongous... What?
It's a Central American murder log.
Ah, of the murder logs.
Yep.
You think it's a log until it bites you.
This has been at least 12 inches maybe, because this used to be 5 feet tall. And this is where kids are encouraged to measure themselves to a little star. 5 feet tall, you know, the wingspan is 3 meters almost. Yes, two of them got in California. Two jumping stars got in California.
Ah, clapping. Searching. Oh, there you go. Found some things. Some folks.
No, the wingspan is 8 feet. It stands 5 feet up.
I know, but the wingspan is taller than that. Yeah.
That's a different jungle or something.
That's so crazy. You got a picture of him.
Open it? No.
So you didn't want the tapir spit, and you didn't want the fiberglass.
Look, man, your hand's gonna fall off by the end of today. I have no part in that.
I've been touched by a tapir before.
If we get to see this guy, he's a huge one. I think a photograph going around. Of that's some guy holding a crocodile here at the zoo.
Oh, look, iguana. Iguana, Diego.
Oh.
Here?
In front of Diego.
Oh, it's right
here. Oh, there's the crocodile. And the iguana.
Oh, the crocodile is right here.
Huh?
Oh, my.
Oh, dang.
Shows how easily I would have gotten eaten. Yeah.
Look at the iguana. Look at the iguana. Look at the iguana.
Iguana.
Chomp.
I want to
compare the size of those two.
Oh, my God. That's what will come for me if I try to go for a swim.
Two little iguanas here. They feel safe next to the crocodile.
Don't come for me, please. Tell your family, don't come for me.
Do you know the difference between a crocodile and an alligator?
I genuinely don't. I'm always trying to figure out what is the difference.
Teeth. You see one in a while, and you see the other one later.
The other iguana is edible.
It's the teeth.
And this one's crocodile?
Yeah.
But these are the spiny teeth.
And now they're shaped and...
Oh, they're eating something that was, there's bird meat on the ground here.
Oh,
yeah. Teeth shaping the mouth rather than the mouth shaping the teeth.
Yellow-headed parrot.
The African gray parrots.
Oh, yellow-headed parrot.
African gray parrots, like the yellow-headed parrot.
What the
color is it? This is someone who has la gente.
Sí, pero el cabeza amarilla es el que habla. Yeah, the most talkative parrot in the world is the African gray parrot.
Gabla?
Followed by the yellow-headed parrot, which we have in Belize.
Mmm.
The parrots will
look really tasty. That's what he was holding.
The yellow-headed parrots will.
Tasty, you said?
Tasty.
No, you cannot establish a conversation. They will repeat everything you say and. And most of the time, people teach them to insult, you know?
Yeah.
So if you find a rude parrot, they taught him to be rude. As you can see, he has surplus food and a lot of fruits, and he has a nice eating dish here, see?
Yeah, they got all kinds of food.
So they treat these guys really nice, better than me.
Papaya,
she has watermelon, she has... Yeah, they have surplus food, as you can see.
Yeah, what? You shudder.
Yeah, I like it.
Yeah.
No,
the biggest of our parrots happens to be what just
we have. Of the parrots?
Our parrots. Remember, we have yellow headed. That's big. We have the yellow parrots. We have the parrots. What kind of parrots? But this is our biggest parrot.
The reaction would probably be more painful than that. If you would have like fallen.
Oh god, no. I would return the kick.
We have a food thing here.
Yeah, great. There he is. Oh, yeah.